So ask me.
What are we doing today, Marie?
We're gonna go and try to pick the yams so that they have a chance to cure for Thanksgiving. I've been holding off picking them. I have picked off slips and they've already started to root again, so that's very exciting. But let's go and look! Yay! Ah, look at that.
Keep digging.
Might not.
Look at it, there's two.
Yeah. There's three.
Three.
Oh, and a little skinny one.
Yeah.
Look at that. I don't know if there's, I don't think anything else ripped off. Oh, nope. Yeah, there's another one.
Oh my goodness.
There's another one.
Wow.
And more.
Wow. Okay, so we have to do a sweet potato pie then, I think.
They grew. And I started these slips in March.
Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful.
Look at those.
That's the first. Here is our sweet potato harvest from our 4-foot grow bag in the front. And then also I had two kind of 10-gallon pots in the back. So these are the large, and then I've got some medium sized ones, and just so you can see. So they're not large like in a store, but you know, here's my hand nearby it. So you can see, then medium, and then these little stragglers. I did notice, like, you know, they do have some roots. These ones, they probably could have stayed in longer, looking at that, the root bit of them. There are some that have a little bit of this, you know, wormy hole, so I don't know what that's going to entail, but right now I am curing them, and so they need to cure for 2 to 3 weeks. So I guess we're not going to eat them for Thanksgiving. We could eat them for Thanksgiving, but they're starchier and not as sweet, so they're not great for baking. So these might be my Christmas yams that we'll get to do. I also have kept all of the greens from them, because apparently you can eat the greens, and I do believe that use those to actually start my next slip. So I will have really good strong roots, and also it'll allow me to sell some of my yam slips to others. So I already have, I do believe, 10 in the studio now. That I started probably about a month ago, maybe 2 months ago. So their roots are good and strong, as you can see. And, but I would like to add some more so that I can turn around and give them away or sell them, as I said. So, also, I have moved all the peppers and things, so I'll let you have a peekaboo at that. So I found out that over the last couple years that peppers are not an annual, they are a perennial. And so I dug up my peppers and I did keep them out and just put them in a little mini greenhouse. And then as soon as I did that, they just started to give me lots. I learned a lot about peppers this year, that you don't plant your sweet peppers and your hot peppers together. Your sweet get hot, your hot get sweet. And also they don't like as much heat like they do like heat, but they don't want to have it constant. They do need some shade. So I will be doing my peppers differently. So there again are the 10 yam slips there. So I'm going to use some of the leaves that we picked from the yams and start more slips. So that'll be very exciting. So it'll be exciting to be back into the studio greenhouse and be prepping for next year and just cultivating what we have. The peppers, I will let them grow a little bit longer and I will pull them off. I'll let them ripen. And then I do have to come and do, from what I've seen on video, a real harsh pruning. But anyway, that's all that I did today. Well, I did a whole bunch of other stuff, but you didn't need to be a part of that.